Air Jordan 36 Heatwave. Alright, so what's up YouTube? If you're a sneaker aficionado such as myself and you like content like this, best way to support me and the channel is to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Alright, so just another quick pickup video, y'all. Got the Air Jordan 36 in the Heatwave colorway. This wasn't my favorite colorway initially, obviously. The Jordan 6 inspired colorways are always going to be my favorite, you know, going back to the OGs. But I remember the first time I saw these, Carmelo was wearing them, and we just got like a little shot of him wearing them on the court. And my first impression, I was blown away at the colorway. And normally I'm not really into the new colors or, you know, the colorful things with multiple colors. I'm pretty much a traditionalist when it comes to J's, you know, Bulls colors and a lot of the early non-Bulls colors, you know, True Blues, Militaries, Grapes. But when I first saw these on Melo's feet, I was like, man, those are fire. And they're kind of, you know, they've got the Laker colors in here. They're, you know, they've got the purple on the back. Obviously, the yellow accenting on the heel, yellow Jumpman, and it does come to the yellow on the tip of the toe. And I did have my time, you know, when Kobe was in the league still, when he was still playing during his run, there was a time I was rooting for Kobe, so therefore rooting for the Lakers. Therefore wearing purple and yellow quite a bit, so, but I haven't worn it that much, certainly in the last 5 years. And I was going to get these initially. I was like, you know, I'll go ahead and cop a pair just to have a different colorway to wear that's not all Bulls colors. And because these were supposed to drop after the first colorway, after the Psychic Energy colorway, that's when these were originally supposed to drop. So I was gonna use these to kind of carry me over in between that colorway and then the black infrareds. But then once it, you know, was kind of showing that the black infrared was gonna drop first, I kind of waned on these. I was like, I don't need them anymore. Cause I didn't think I'd wear them that much between the other two colors, you know, the Psychic Energy, the black infrared, and then the Glories. I figured these wouldn't really make that rotation. But then they showed up on the release date list on a lot of sites, and they finally dropped, stopped getting pushed back. And they were kind of there for the taking, so I said, you know what, I'll go ahead and get them. Better to get them now at retail than to try to find them later. And, you know, if I didn't want them, I could just sell them or something, sell them down the road if they didn't really make the rotation. Then getting them in person, these are really nice, man. These are really nice, really well done. I like the sunset or heat wave concept. Even though when you look up close, the way they did it with the Leno weave, like the colors literally just blend into each other. So like you can see here, there's literally lines. When you get into the details of it, you can see the lines of the colors as they start to blend. You know, it's not perfectly grading. As you can see, it literally just, you know, it's just lines, you know, one color transitioning into another. So it's not a smooth gradient, but, you know, on foot and starting from a distance, it's still gonna look nice. The one thing I do question with this shoe is the outsole. I mean, I like the marbling effect with it. I like the marbling effect. It's just why, I question why they chose to go with gray. Like, it's literally a light gray and a dark gray. And there's no other gray on the shoe, so I find that kind of strange. Maybe they didn't want to take away from the Heatwave effect on the upper by using some of those same colors in the outsole. I would have preferred, you know, if they were going to use gray, I think I would have preferred a black outsole with maybe like a dark gray marbling. Since the rest of the shoe, other than the Heatwave upper, is pretty black. But outside of that, I mean, that's really my only complaint. And it's really not a big one. Also, the iridescent finish, I'm not sure if they're going to, you should be able to see it. The line in the midsole has that iridescent finish. Like, my first shoe that comes to mind is the Chaos Kobe 7. You should be able to see it, especially right on the heel right there, moving it back and forth. So the iridescent finish is actually a really nice touch on these. Even though I don't know what it necessarily has to do with the Heatwave concept, but I don't really care. It's really nice. So yeah, this is just a great colorway. I do plan on just wearing these casually. I'm not gonna hoop in them, but yeah, they popped up and they were sitting there. So I said, you know what? F it, I'll get them. but yeah, that's pretty much gonna be it on this one. Did y'all cop these? Let me know down in the comment section. It seems like a lot of the shipping issues that had, you know, delayed these and seemingly a lot of other releases is kind of cleared up now. So, you know, the 36s are starting to come in waves, no pun intended. The green Celtics colorway, or Jason Tatum colorway, just dropped. The lows are supposed to drop this month, May. And it seems like that date's actually going to hold now. So hopefully these 36s that we've been seeing, and, you know, the dates keep getting pushed back. Hopefully it seems like they're actually dropping now. But yeah, that's going to be it on this one. Peace out.